Coach, a gritty effort by your team today. Just came up one run short. What did you tell them after the game?
Well, I'm trying to be the educator for them, and obviously we're frustrated, and that's hard. That was a hard loss. I thought, again, the F troop, the guys on Friday night that we've put a plan together of them pitching a certain amount of innings gave us a chance again. I said to them, the way the people walk out of the stadium, the way we feel walking out of the stadium, the way the media will talk about it will be the drop fly ball by Biley in the eighth inning. The reality is that the fourth and fifth inning, when we give them four walks, a hit batter, and a pass ball, adds to this defeat. In the sixth inning, we have second and third and no outs, and we don't score a run, adds to this defeat. And I'm trying to teach them of when you do certain things, it allows you to win. And we're not doing that. And that's what's so frustrating. And I know it's hard on them. It's just like it's hard on me, too. But they've got to learn it isn't that Kentucky won the game. We lost the game. And that's what hurts the most is that, you tip your hat to them. They came out on top. But we gave them everything that they took advantage of it. And we've got to continue to work to shore that up. And like I told them, we got to learn how to win, too. And that's not an easy characteristic to have. You have to find a way to bottle that up when you get it and never let it get away.
Do you take anything away or anything from the fact that this team did battle back after giving up a three spot in the eighth?
Well, I'm glad you said that, because that was the first thing I said to them out there, is that no matter what anyone says about this team, no matter what the season ends up, and we still have a long ways to go, is that no one could ever say this team quits, because we could easily folded up the tent after that eighth inning, and we were deflated, and we came back, and the little things matter. Parker Wormsley starts the inning and gets out. But Parker Wormsley probably got the momentum going for us because of that great at-bat he had off of their closer. He's probably not used to guys having that kind of at-bat, and I think that led to us having the winning run on first base.
Talk a little bit about A.J. Simcox's game today. He's really seemed to step up his game in SEC play. Three more hits today.
Well, I had three more hits. The thing for me that I'll continue to talk about with A.J. is that we want him to continue to play solid defense. That's the most important for him right now on this team. It helps when he's offensive too, but his defense is what matters the most to me right now. But he had a good day at the plate.
He had a couple good plays on the field today too.
Yeah, he did. He made a real good play in the sixth hole, came up and showed off his good arm. That's all we're continuing to ask him to do, is play good defense and just execute. Probably the one thing that I'll say is A.J. had a great day at the plate, but he needs to get those bunts down when we need to execute. And that's what his role is right now. We're not asking him to go out and go 3-for-4 or 3-for-5 every day. We want to play good defense and execute. It'll be his day one day down the line when he's going to be more of an offensive guy for us. But right now, it's his role is to play defense and execute.
Just talk about the team's mindset with Nick Williams going out on the mound tomorrow. What do you expect from him?
Well, the mindset better be good. I mean, we're devastated. That was another game that we played right with a team. Tomorrow's a new day. We wake up, we have breakfast, we come to the field, and Nick hopefully will have some leadership, show some leadership, and take the bull by the horns and give us a chance, just like most of the pitchers did today.